Solutions.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello,
audience.
Hello.
This is Graham.
This is Ashkahn.
And our question for today is someone who's curious about the role of UV in UV plus H2O2 systems.
Okie dokie. So what does the UV do in the UV H2O2?
And what the heck is UV in H2O2, I guess?
We can start with that. There's just a lot of letters, huh? All right, well, so UV stands for ultraviolet, which is ultraviolet light, which is a spectrum of light.
And which in this case is a UV light filter, is that what they call them?
Filter.
No, just UV light.
I think the bulb just
mechanism?
Produces, that spectrum of light.
Well, what's the name for like the actual container?
Oh.
Just a UV light that you attach to your...
UV light unit?
Unit? Okay, anyway. That's when the role of UV means. What's the role of that UV unit in here?
And H2O2 means hydrogen peroxide.
Yeah.
Clear the acronyms out of the way here.
And in refers to something being inside of something else.
This is an interesting question, and it's actually a really good one for everybody in the industry to get right, because this is one of those things where if you're talking to someone from the health department world and you're kind of not phrasing this the right way, then you get sideways glances and you get people, you know, nervous about your operations and stuff like that.
Yeah, and maybe even coming down a little harder on you than they should.
Right. So...
So feel free to listen to this one a few hundred times.
Yeah.
You know, make sure you're really comfortable with it.
basically, the UV and hydrogen peroxide when used together is really the only way you want to use hydrogen peroxide. So kind of the big lesson to take out of this is that, you know, as far as we know, I guess, from everything we've looked into and the people we've talked to kind of who know more about this than we do, it really seems that hydrogen peroxide is probably not strong enough by itself to kind of meet the level of cleanliness that we're looking for in the water. So the key takeaway is don't just use hydrogen peroxide by itself. Like it's UV and hydrogen peroxide kind of form this system together. And in that system, the UV is kind of doing the heavy lifting.
Yeah, if anything, you should almost consider it a UV system with hydrogen peroxide.
Yeah, and they play different roles. Like, they definitely help each other, and they work well together. And so basically UV is doing the kind of actual, you know, killing of the viruses. Actually, technically, it doesn't really kill them. UV, like, most effectively, as far as I know, basically stops the reproduction of various kind of pathogens and bacteria and
bugs
microorganisms.
Almost everyone likes to call them.
Quote-unquote bugs in the water. So the UV light does a good job of just kind of destroying like the RNA and sometimes the DNA of these different bugs. And so while they may still be present in the water, they're kind of effectively not able to grow to the point of being harmful to somebody in most cases. So that's actually different than how chlorine and bromine work and other things like that. So UV kind of has this special way of killing stuff.
And as a result, it works really effectively against things that even chlorine and bromine don't work against. As long as you're able to keep the right intensity of, like, pretty much as long as the UV is doing its stuff, the water that's passing through that UV light comes out the other end pretty safe.
Yeah, and there's a lot of details about UV lights working correctly and stuff like that, which maybe we want to go into the scope
of
this email.
Or another daily solution.
Or this episode.
Email.
I'm just really used to answering emails. But you have a UV light, it's all working correctly and set up well and powerful enough and all that sort of stuff. If it's all doing the things it should be doing, then it's basically taking those bugs and kind of destroying their ability to reproduce. And then the hydrogen peroxide comes in and does something slightly different, which is really helpful, which is hydrogen peroxide seems to be a really good oxidizer, which is a word that you hear a lot. And you're going to learn, if you're ever dealing with the stuff or talking to health departments, that these different words have really specific meanings to them. Like, you can't just say disinfectant and cleaner and sanitizer and sterilizer, like, interchangeably. Those all kind of mean different things to health departments when you're talking to them.
And if you do think they mean the same thing, maybe we should take a second to actually describe those ones specifically, since that relates exactly to what we're talking about here.
Yeah, I mean, disinfection is the one that you hear the most from health departments, and that has a very both technical and often legal meaning behind it, which is that a disinfectant in at least if we're talking about the pool and spa world for a second, which is, you know, often what health departments are trying to categorize this under. So if you're talking pool and spa stuff and you're talking to a health department person and they say the word disinfectant, they're actually looking for something registered by the EPA to be a disinfectant in your specific application. So like chlorine is a registered disinfectant for pools and spas, which means the EPA has gone through, you know, a process where they've approved it for use. And then most health departments, if not all of them in the United States, are kind of legally required to only allow these EPA registered disinfectants to be used for these applications. And it often means that it's killing a certain level of like a quantifiable way of killing stuff too. So they'll measure against certain bugs and they'll measure a certain amount of how fast and how much it can kill those bugs. And if it meets all those, you know, technical guidelines, then you can call it a disinfectant. So you can't just call anything a disinfectant. And often what happens is people will say hydrogen peroxide is the disinfectant I'm using. And that's kind of where you start getting into trouble because one, it's not a registered disinfectant for not even pools and spas and not float tanks. So there's, you know.
Yeah, the only one I know about is it being registered for hard surface.
As a hard surface
disinfectant.
Yeah, exactly,
hard surface disinfectant.
Often mixed with other stuff to make it, those kind of.
So you might, if you do a little research, you might find things of hydrogen peroxide as a disinfectant, but
right.
That's not for the applications that we're talking about.
Yeah, exactly. So that's one place where, like, if you were to approach a health department and saying, hey, I'm using hydrogen peroxide as my disinfectant in here, they'd be like, I can't allow you to do that, you know? And it's funny because you can actually just say, I'm using hydrogen peroxide as an oxidizer in here.
And then they'll nod about, oh, yes, yes,
yeah.
Well, that makes sense, yeah.
So it is amazing how much of it comes down to just, like, the language that you're using. And so oxidizers specifically are something that kind of burn up organic materials in the liquid that they're in. So while UV, you know, a lot of these things are combinations, right? Like chlorine can kill stuff and is a good oxidizer, as well as I think ozone is too. I think ozone's a decent oxidizer. And UV is not a great oxidizer, right? It's just shooting these kind of light rays at things. And so the hydrogen peroxide works well in conjunction with it because it can go take those things that the UV light has blasted and kind of burn them up and, you know, get that stuff out of the liquid. And so they work well as a pair for that reason. They also work well as a pair because UV and peroxide, when used in combination, when that UV light hits the hydrogen peroxide, create these things called hydroxyl radicals. And those hydroxyl radicals are really good at killing stuff. They seem to be very effective. They're very hard to measure. Like, they only last milliseconds, it seems, from what we've heard.
So you can almost view it as, like, a boost to your UV light rather than as a boost to your hydrogen peroxide.
Right.
Right? It's not like you supercharged your H2O2 and now you have these super H2O2 molecules floating around in your water. It's more like...
It's like a synergistic effect, right? So it actually, like, it's the effect you get from it is better than the sum of the UV by itself and the peroxide by itself.
And
like, it actually creates this very strong sort of thing in there.
And it's like, it really, you can almost view it as, in my mind, supercharging the UV experience is how I view it. Like, the hydroxyl radicals are created right there at the UV light. It's...
Sure. Yeah, in that sense, yeah. So, like, that is an important distinction, is that they, because they only last for such a short period of time, that these things are probably only really affecting stuff that's moving through your filtration system, likely kind of right inside
the
UV light.
Pretty much, like, when it's going through the UV light is also when the hydroxyl radicals are doing their thing. It's not like you end up with a residual of hydroxyl radicals that are
floating
around. Exactly.
So, you know, it puts a little bit more pressure on making sure the liquid kind of moves through your filtration system. There's a greater importance to your turnovers and stuff like that when you're kind of relying on those hydroxyl radicals and UV in general, right? I mean, that's the thing with UV. It's not like chlorine and bromine are just in the water. Like, you can take a sample of any section of water in a pool or spa and like there's chlorine and bromine in it. Whereas a UV light is only exposed to things that are passing straight through that UV unit. There's not UV waves like emanating out into the rest of your basin or whatever. So, you know, it puts different importance on different parts of your filtration system. But really the important thing to realize here is that it's kind of UV's leading the way there. When you think about these UV peroxide systems, you should consider UV kind of as the front man for all of this, and the peroxide is kind of the, like, in the sidecar, buddy cop sort of person hanging out and helping out.
Yeah, which is why, I mean, I at this point always call them UV H2O2 systems as opposed to H2O2 UV systems, which I guess mathematically is the exact same thing, but puts the importance, I guess, at the right part of the...
Or really just talking about peroxide without the UV as well. You know, if you're talking to a health department and you're talking a lot about how you're using hydrogen peroxide, just, you know, make sure you're talking about it as a system and these two things being used in conjunction with each other, and not just kind of peroxide by itself is what's doing the job in there.
If you are just using peroxide by itself, you should probably get a UV unit hooked up to that.
Yeah. You know, and none of this, like, this is based a lot on the information we know about hydrogen peroxide and other applications. Like, there hasn't been a lot of testing, you know.
Yeah, I mean, it could totally come out that it is actually okay to use hydrogen peroxide by itself, but that's making a huge leap from our current level of understanding. Like, we don't know what the ultimate conclusion would be, but my guess is that we'll find out that it's probably not okay just by itself. That's just my hunch right now.
And most people's. The people who are smarter than us and know more about us than this seem to have that conclusion.
More about it than us? No one knows more about us than us.
Some people out there. You never know. but yeah, certainly I've never talked to someone who's come away from this thinking like the peroxide's probably fine by itself. It's usually the conclusion. Their hunch is that you need the UV in there.
And definitely that's the case for health departments, too. Like, they will certainly assume that. If you're talking about H2O2 alone as being enough, like, that's, again, those sidelong glances and disapproving scraping of their fingers.
So, yeah, what's the role of UV? It's a big one. It's a big role.
Big role. And there you have it.
Yep. Okay, well, if you guys have other questions, you can always hop over to floattanksolutions.com/podcast and, you know, We might consider answering them.
It's our job.
It is our job, technically. Yeah, so we'll probably answer them. All right.
Bye.
Bye.